Hello and welcome to the Wednesday, November 9th, 2022 edition of the Sands and its Storm Centers Stormcast. My name is Johannes Ulrich and today I'm recording from Jacksonville, Florida. Well, today, of course, Microsoft's Patch Tuesday, and that's, of course, what we'll spend a good part of this podcast with. We got patches for a total of 68 vulnerabilities. 10 of these vulnerabilities are rated as critical. One has previously been disclosed, and 4 are already being exploited, which may sort of be a record, not 100% sure, but let's talk a little bit about some of these vulnerabilities, and there are some fairly interesting ones here. First of all, Mark of the Web. I mentioned this a few times in this podcast. Tends to be difficult to really close all the gaps here. The idea is that files are marked as they're being downloaded from online resources. One issue apparently here was that if a file was write protected, then the mark of the web could not be applied to it. We also had, of course, in the past problems with archives and such. Not 100% sure how much of this will be addressed here, but one of the vulnerabilities already disclosed and already being exploited, the other one neither. But the second vulnerability here is also more likely to be exploited according to Microsoft. Now, these are only important, of course, because there's no sort of immediate code execution, anything like this, due to this vulnerability. We also got then another Windows Print Spooler elevation of privilege vulnerability already being exploited. Looks like a variation of that Print Nightmare that we had a while ago. Seems like almost every month we get another little patch about this here from Microsoft. And then a Windows Scripting Languages remote code execution vulnerability also already exploited and with a CVSS score of 8.8. And the last one that's already being exploited is Windows CNG key isolation service vulnerability, and that is a privilege escalation vulnerability as an attacker may obtain keys from other users. That's already, again, being exploited. Now, among the other vulnerabilities here, there's one that sort of stuck out a little bit, and that's a vulnerability in Sysmon. So basically what happens here is Sysmon, if you're not that familiar with it, allows you to monitor various system activities and then remotely log them. Really useful tool often deployed across larger networks. And this vulnerability now allows for a privilege escalation all the way back to the administrator. Now, Microsoft rated this particular vulnerability as less likely to be exploited. However, I have already seen a working exploit for this, so it doesn't appear to be all that difficult. And it's one of those cases, yes, it's only a privilege escalation vulnerability, but it's where essentially your security tools, Sysmon in this case, sort of built kind of an infrastructure across your network that allows for this exploit to happen. And interestingly, we also got patches for OpenSSL. Not 100% sure where this is used in Microsoft's system, but sure they're using it somewhere. So this is one of those things you just basically get with all the other patches. So interesting patches, not really a lot of vulnerabilities. I think 68 is a little bit on the lower end here, but a number of interesting vulnerabilities being addressed here. So certainly don't delay applying this update. But as customary for Patch Tuesday, we don't just have patches from Microsoft. We also got a critical patch from VMware for VMware Workspace 1. This patch fixes 5 vulnerabilities and 3 of them are rated as critical. An authentication bypass vulnerability, a broken authentication method vulnerability, and a broken access control vulnerability are the 3 critical vulnerabilities being addressed here. None of them have a workaround, and that hacker would be able to get administrative access to your system using these flaws. And talking about access control issues, well, we also got an update from Citrix Gateway and Citrix ADC. This fixes also a number of critical vulnerabilities, one of them unauthorized access to the Gateway user capabilities. There's also sort of a phishing-related vulnerability and brute force protection bypass. Probably the first one here that allows you to just bypass authentication is the one that I would rate critical here, and it does affect your device if you have the VPN gateway enabled. And that's pretty much true for all of them, but the last one, which is also related to the AAA virtual server. Citrix ADC is, of course, always good for some interesting exploits and vulnerabilities. Remember, this is the device that's actually still running a Perl code sort of on the back end, and not surprised that there are some interesting issues left to discover. Now, talking about interesting vulnerabilities, there is a little bit of postscript here to the Microsoft updates, and that's Exchange. You may have noticed that none of the Exchange vulnerabilities are already being exploited, but we do have these outstanding vulnerabilities that we are waiting for a patch for that are already being exploited in Exchange. That vulnerability, however, was apparently patched. There is a blog from Microsoft, I'll link to it in the show notes, that states that they have been patched. There is also Exchange update that's being mentioned here for server 2013, 16, and 19 that supposedly does fix this update, but the vulnerabilities are not listed, so maybe they were delayed a little bit. Not sure exactly what's happening here. Watch out for these Exchange server updates, and yes, they will be delivered again as sort of a separate security update for Exchange server as sort of a self-extracting, auto-elevating executable. Well, that's it for today, so thanks a lot for listening, and talk to you again tomorrow. Bye.